Hey, come in, sir.
Yes.
Good morning, sir.
Please have a seat.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Gaurav, without making any direct or indirect references to your religion, caste or gender, introduce yourself to the board in terms of values and virtues that you hold very dear.
Sir, I'm Gaurav. I'm from Azamgarh, Uttar Pradesh. I have done engineering from Jamia Millia Islamia. And as far as values go, I'm a person of integrity. I have compassion for the lower sections of the society. And I'm very passionate towards the public service.
Okay. Gaurav, how would you define integrity? What is integrity according to you?
Sir, I will say that integrity is doing the right thing when nobody is watching. Even if I can get away with doing wrong thing, but still I am doing the right thing. That is the integrity.
Any world leader whom you find he or she is the epitome of integrity in the present or in the past?
Sir, the name that comes to my mind first is Mahatma Gandhi. Our late Prime Minister Shri Lal Bahadur Shastri was also a man of great integrity.
Gaurav, you celebrate your birthday on 27th of March.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the significance of that date? Something great is also celebrated on that date. Are you aware of it?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware.
It's the World Theatre Day.
Yes, sir.
You also happen to come from Uttar Pradesh?
Yes, sir.
Can you name some theatre forms from Uttar Pradesh?
Sir, in our area, like there, Nautanki is there, Ramlila is there. I do not know whether it will fit into the theater form, but Ramlila is like it is one of the most prominent folk art that is practiced.
Have you heard about Swam?
Yes, sir.
Raslila?
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about Raslila as a form of theater art.
Sir, Raslila is basically the enacting of Lord Krishna and his playfulness and his life when he was in Vrindavan and his connection with the gopis and all the great things that he has done for the people. So that is the enactment of that life of Lord Krishna, earlier part of his life.
Gaurav, who is an artist according to you? How do you define an artist?
Sir, as per me, an artist is somebody who creates something new and who is able to evoke emotions in someone else. Artist is not somebody who just portray or who just imitate what is already in nature, but he creates something new, and by creating that new a novelty, he evokes a certain emotion in the person who watches his art. Maybe it's painting, singing, movies, any.
Who is your favorite artist?
Sir, in different fields, I have different favorites. Like,
name anyone.
So like Sudarshan Patnaik, he's a great sand artist who makes great sand sculptures.
What value do you like in him?
His sculptures are usually based on the contemporary current events. So whatsoever happens, he creates something which evokes a kind of emotions. Like when our soldiers have been martyred in Chhattisgarh, he created a sculpture for that. And those things they create a certain reaction and emotion among people, and
that's his message, Gaurav.
Yes,
what
sir.
Value do you like in him as an artist? All artists hold some values?
Yes, sir.
What value in him attracts you? Sudarshan Patnaik.
Sorry, sir. I do not know him personally. Like, I haven't seen
him. Don't you feel his art exhibits some values? Have you been following his art?
Yes, sir. Sir, I would say that he represents day-to-day life, very mundane things. But then he, even in those mundane things, he creates something which is very, I would say, which evokes a kind of emotion in that mundane activities that he creates. And he uses like not a lot of color. It is only sand and few colors he uses. But in that I would say a black and white image also, he creates a certain imagery which is very important.
Okay. Have you heard about the term grand old man of India?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about the term grand old lady of India?
Yes, sir.
Who is the grand old lady?
So, Srimati Aruna Asaf Ali is called Grand Old Lady of India.
Tell me something about her.
Sir, she played a very important role in our national freedom movement. She took active part in Quit India movement. In fact, she hosted the Congress flag in Mumbai. Gwalior Tank Maidan, I guess, where this thing was happening. And she was the member of Congress Socialist Party, but in latter part of her life, she joined Communist Party of India. And even after independence, she remained active in politics. She became the first mayor of Delhi. And she is also awarded with the highest Indian honor.
To which Satyagraha we relate her the most?
Salt Satyagraha.
Salt Satyagraha?
Yes, sir.
You come from Azamgarh, or?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the neighboring districts of Azamgarh? How many neighboring districts?
Sir, I have to count like Mau.
Take your time.
Mau, Gorakhpur, Ghazipur, Jaunpur, Ambedkar Nagar, Sultanpur. Six.
That's it? Are you sure about it?
Sir, I'm not sure, but these are the things that come to my mind.
Okay, Mau is on which side of Azamgarh? Northeast, northwest, southwest, southeast.
Sir, it is southeast.
Are you sure about
that? Sir, not very sure, but.
Okay. Hindi happens to be your mother tongue.
Yes, sir.
Gaurav, have you heard about Hindi Pakwada?
Yes, sir.
When is it celebrated?
Sir, I do not remember the exact date, but I know the month it is celebrated in September.
Okay. It is celebrated by which organ of the government? Which body is in charge for the celebration of Hindi Pakwada? Have you heard something like Hindi Saptah?
Yes, sir.
Which body is responsible for its celebration?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware.
Have you heard about Rajbhasha Department?
Yes, sir.
Rajbhasha Department comes under which ministry?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
It's Ministry of Home Affairs. You also happen to be a civil engineer.
Yes, sir.
In fact, I find it quite interesting that civil engineering is your optional subject too.
Yes, sir.
In the examination. Can you tell me something about geomechanical inverse modeling?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
You're not aware of it?
No, sir.
What about uncertainty quantification?
No, sir.
No idea?
No, sir.
Okay. Tell me three steps by which we can improve the quality of national highways in this country. Three steps and put them into priority.
Sir, the first step that I would say is the preparation of subgrade, because that is very important, and at many places we see that the compaction is not adequate, and therefore many problems happen at a later date.
What is this self-healing concrete?
Sir, self-healing concrete is a new form of concrete in which certain microorganisms are there, which if there is a crack in concrete, they will heal itself and they will basically secrete calcium carbonate, and that crack gets filled, and therefore the porosity of concrete
Can this decreases. Self-healing process take place without the aid of microorganisms? If yes, then what is the alternative way?
Sir, I'm sure it can take place, but I'm not aware of the technology.
That was the first step. Go on.
Sir, the second thing that I would say that our highways need is the maintenance, because we put a lot of money in construction, but in India we generally ignore maintenance, and because of that our like road quality, as at least the surface quality, is not very good. And the third I would say is the traffic management. So the speed limits or the intersections, they have to be designed with engineering principles to have an optimum flow on the road.
Gaurav, you have done your BTech from
Jamia
Millia. Is that a minority institution?
Yes, sir. Sir, when I joined it, it was a central university then, but later it got the.
Is it a minority institution?
Yes, sir, it is a minority.
Under which article of the Indian Constitution, minority institutions enjoy their cultural and educational rights?
sir, under Article 30.
Sure.
Yes, sir.
You must be aware of the recent row with respect to Aligarh Muslim University, AMU.
Yes, sir.
There was a row very recently, not much time has lapsed, with respect to a portrait of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, which was hanging in the Students' Union Hall of AMU.
Yes, sir.
And there were protests to take that portrait down. What are your views with respect to that portrait? Do you favor its hanging or do you want it to be brought down?
Sir, I believe that if a portrait is already there, then there is no need to bring it down. Muhammad Ali Jinnah played a great role in our freedom movement, even though like in latter part of his life, his politics towards turned towards communalism. But a portrait can remind us of great things, and it can also remind us of failures, of the bad things that have happened, and we should take a lesson from it. So I think portrait per se has no harm. Like even in Germany, there are museums for Holocaust. And it is like a shame for them that they are, it can be, but they have it so that the next generations can learn from them the kind of trauma, the kind of sufferings that Holocaust put on people. So I believe that the portrait, it has a meaning, it has a significance, and it should be there.
Are there any portraits of Adolf Hitler in Israel?
Sir, I'm not aware of it, but I'm sure there will be no portraits.
Okay. You have got excellent marks throughout your career. I see 96% in 10, 12, 93. Then you did excellently in your BTEC, 9.92. Even in MTEC, 9.79. That's handsome marks, Gaurav.
Thank you, sir.
Why do you want to be a bureaucrat? You should be an academician. Don't you think by being an academician, you can serve the society more? You have great interest in learning. Your marks are a reflection of that. And by doing some qualitative, intangible research, you could contribute to the society much better. Don't you think that you are in the wrong path?
Sir, I do not think that I am on a wrong path. Even as a bureaucrat, I can serve the society. Moreover, in bureaucracy, I can get the hands-on experience that means I can work at the grassroots level. So maybe right now, my all knowledge is very bookish. What I have learned from books. And once in service, I will get the real knowledge, like the practical knowledge, how things happen. And even if I want to turn to research or being an academician at latter part of my life, I believe that both the experiences will help me a lot and I'll be a better academician that way.
You have secured third position in 17th National Youth Parliament Competition.
Yes, sir.
Tell me about something about that competition that year. What was the major theme for that competition that year in which you won the third prize?
Sir, it was like the enactment of the whole parliament. I was the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gases that time. And that time, the price of gas, petroleum products were increasing, like very steep. And so a member of opposition called me, asked questions from me about like why prices are increasing and what is being done about it. And I answered that question. So that was my role. And apart from that, the other things were like terrorist attacks that happened in India and what is being done for the security of citizens, etc.
Democracy and youth. If I say these words, what comes to your mind? Democracy and youth.
So India comes to my mind because India is the like biggest democracy and a major portion of our population is young.
Young, good. Painting,
yes, sir.
Is one of your hobbies. What do you like to paint? What is the subject matter of your paintings?
Sir, usually I paint natural landscapes, freehand natural landscapes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
So when you painted the last landscape,
yes, sir.
When did you do that?
Sir, it was last lockdown, like when I got time.
So
a lot of
what kind of landscape you chose?
Sir, it was setting sun basically. It was evening time, setting landscape and a river.
Does the sun really sets?
But it appears to be setting. It does.
Why do we call it the universal truth? rising and setting sun is universal truth. Yes. The truth is something which happens.
Yes.
But you are saying that the sun never sets.
Sir, means technically speaking, sun never sets. But if we see from Earth and in the general folklore, it is seen as rising in the morning and setting in the evening, and it happens every day. It
so
happens
being an engineer,
failing. Yes, sir.
Should you take a line of thought which is there generally in the folklore, or you should go by logic and reason?
Sir, I believe logic and reason has its significance, but maybe while I'm discussing in that context or that kind of subject matter, then I will go for a thing like this. But if I'm talking in a general term, I think that going by what is general folklore is not very wrong.
Any one particular painter whom you like?
Sir, I like Abhinandanath Tagore, Nandlal Bose, and I also like...
Have you heard about Bharat Mata?
Yes, sir.
What is so significant about that painting? It is made by whom?
Sir, Abhinandanath Tagore.
What is so special about that painting?
Sir, in that painting, our country, India, is portrayed as a lady, Bharat Mata. She is wearing a saffron sari. She has four hands. In one hand, she has cereals. In one hand, she has books. In other hand, she has a piece of cloth. So, which signifies that all India that stands for that we need food, we need clothing, we need education. So, it is a very significant portrayal of India at that point of time.
Okay. Thank you, Gaurav. Azamgarh?
Yes, sir.
In the moment we hear the word name Azamgarh, a lot of ideas flow into the mind. What is so special about Azamgarh?
Sir, Azamgarh is a very ancient land. It has been part of the Koshal Mahajanpad. It took a very important part in Indian national movement. It was very active in 1857 revolt, and then it took part in Quit India movement also. Azamgarh has also produced a lot of great poets like Kafi Azmi, Ayodhya Singh Prasad Haryod, and some philosophers like Allama Shibli Nomani and Rahul Sankityayan.
But of late, negative emotions come to play when we hear Azamgarh.
Yes, sir.
Why so?
Sir, in recent past, a few of the terrorists that have been arrested in Delhi and in Mumbai, they hailed from Azamgarh, and therefore this negative image or connotation of Azamgarh was created.
Who is the current MP from Azamgarh?
Sir, Shri Akhilesh Prasad Yadav.
Okay, and I also understand you said it's an ancient land. So, is it associated with any old sage as such?
Yes, sir. Sir, Azamgarh has an ashram of Agastya Muni and Chandrama Muni.
Okay. There's a very famous temple also. Very famous temple in Azamgarh.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
Gold medal in BTEC and MTEC.
Yes, sir.
Very impressive.
Thank you, sir.
Two research papers. Good. What were their book?
Sir, they were about self-compacting concrete. Basically, nowadays, self-compacting concrete is... and I also made that self-compacting concrete using the recycled aggregates. Recycled aggregates are the demolished concrete, and the aggregates are made from that. So usually that recycled aggregates nowadays are used for inferior quality work like pavement or for filling. But my research was about making a self-compacting concrete using that recycled aggregate, and I also achieved a strength of 60 Newton per millimeter square, which is very significant. And my research paper, it proved that we can use that recycled aggregate in quality works too.
So what is about that research in reality today?
Sir, it is very significant because right now there are plants in Delhi which are making a lot of recycled aggregates and which is being used also. And even government has now said that all the this municipal projects, they will use recycled aggregates.
So how did you get the idea of this particular research?
Sir, my HOD, Shri Mehtab Alam, I worked with him, and he gave me these insights and to encouraged me to work towards it.
These days, a lot of plastic waste also is being used in road construction.
Yes, sir.
What is it about that?
Sir, it is basically plastic coated aggregates. Plastic is melted and the aggregates are coated with it, and it increases the plasticity of the road. It means the bitumen does not bleed when plastic coated aggregates are used in road, and it also helps in remedying that plastic waste which has become a major nuisance these days.
Your subject was transportation engineering in MTech.
Yes, sir.
Now, you know, basically, if you talk in terms of transportation engineering, it relates to road safety in a very big way.
Yes, sir.
What are the three E's of road safety?
Sir, education, enforcement, and I would say efficiency.
No, third E is your line, engineering.
Engineering.
Okay. So, what you talked about, your plastic paved roads and reuse of aggregate, now these are part of engineering.
Yes.
Now, apart from that, there is a big drawback in road safety in the sense that engineering does not only mean this, it also means designing of the roads, designing of the speed breakers, designing of intersections.
Yes, sir.
Where do we lack in that particular field? What suggestions can you give to help improve the system?
Sir, our roads, they have like some bottlenecks or some areas which are very accident prone, and that is because it has not been designed properly, like a stopping side distance or the visible distance for to cross a cross section has not been given. So we have to identify those spots which are accident prone and where some engineering deficiency is there, and we have to remedy them.
You know, what I am asking is, what steps can we take to improve the road engineering situation so that the roads become safer per se?
Sir, the first step will be a proper and adequate designing, and the second will be enforcement.
No, I'm talking of engineering now.
Okay. Sir, the other things that we can do is like many accidents happen at intersections. So we can go for like grade separated intersections. We can have automated traffic lights based on EI maybe, which can sense the flow of traffic and can change its timing accordingly. We can improve the quality of our surfaces that many accidents happen because of a skid and all. And apart from that, we can have like road plantations, roadside plantations to reduce the glare that comes sometimes, and especially during the rainy days.
Roads have become actually a source of agitation, all over the country. You heard about what happened about a year back. Now, the recent farm agitation.
Yes, sir.
So, do you think there's a will lacking to stop this because roads are not meant for this purpose? What can be done about it?
Yes, sir. I'm of the opinion that people have right to protest, but they should not create inconvenience for other people. And road is for general public. And because of these protests that is happening, general public is facing a lot of inconvenience and economy is being affected. So these people should be shifted to a separate site which has been allocated for protests. And the common road should not be encroached upon.
Okay, good. You did an adventure course by... in Darjeeling, HMI.
Yes, sir.
When was this and what was this special course about?
Sir, it was when I was in a school, and the course was about like we were given all the basic training of how to climb a mountain. Like we did indoor climbing and outdoor climbing. There is a Tenjing rock which belongs to Himalayan Mountaineering Institute. And we were like taught the techniques of rappelling, how to tie a knot, what are different techniques, etc. And then we were also taken to treks, long treks in tea gardens, etc.
Okay. there is one more institute in India, Mohra Institute, apart from that.
Yes, sir.
Where is that?
Sir, there is one institute in Uttarakhand and one in Kashmir, Gulmarg.
Gulmarg is also about mountaineering?
Yes, sir. It is like high altitude mountaineering, skiing, and snow clad, like how to climb on a snow clad mountains.
Who founded the National Himalayan Mountaineering Institute?
Sir, our late Prime Minister Shri Jawaharlal Nehru.
Was he instrumental? Who was the person who was instrumental in the idea, the seed?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it.
What is the motto of HMI?
Sorry, sir.
How long was your course that you did there?
Sir, it was 15 days.
15 days. Tenzing Norgay was the one who started this. The idea came from him.
Okay, sir.
And did you take part in any expedition also?
No, sir.
What do you think is the purpose of the mountaineering institutes? How do they help?
So they basically train our youth to be like away from their sedentary lifestyles that we are now all we are living. Different, like it tells us to stay fit, and it also teaches us about a lot of qualities like the importance of communication, patience, trusting each other. Like we have climbing buddies and all. So these qualities, they can imbibe these kind of qualities in our youth. And they also have economic significance because they can act a lot of tourism, because now since disposable income is increasing, and even foreign tourists they can attract.
Good.
Thank you, sir.
Gaurav.
Yes,
tell me how Azamgarh got its name.
Sir, it got its name from one of the king, Azam Khan. They were basically Gautami Rajputs. But he embraced Islam and he took the name Azam Khan, and the Azamgarh was named after him.
So Azam Khan embraced Islam, or someone else in his family did that?
Sir, I'm not sure about it.
It is situated on banks of which river?
Sir, Tauts.
Is it a perennial river?
No, sir.
Gaurav, what are your stands on reservation? Should it continue or not?
Sir, it should continue, but not in present form.
Then what form is
it? I believe that a churning should happen. Because right now what we see that a certain section, only a certain strata of even SCST communities, they get reservation in all their generations. And a large section is still deprived of any kind of reservation. So we should have a kind of rule that if three generations have got reservation, they have benefited from reservation, then they should not get. And means a kind of creamy layer should be introduced in SCST reservation too.
Okay, but it should continue. What are your viewpoints on economy? Aspects-based reservation?
Sir, in my personal belief, I do not support it.
Why?
Sir, because the reservation, when it was originally instituted in our constitution, it was based on economic and, social and educational backwardness. So, like the people who are not socially and educationally backward, they have a lot of social capital. And the government should help them. Like there should be scholarships, there should be more schools like Navodaya Vidyalaya. I have been a student of Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, which is completely free. There can be more schools like Eklavya schools are there. So government should help those students otherwise, rather than giving them a reservation in jobs.
So you mean to say that government step off EWS reservation?
Yes, sir.
That is wrong.
Sir, the matter is sub judice and the judgment has not come still. But if I, my personal opinion is that the focus should be on preparing our students so that their economic deprivation should not affect their educational achievements, rather than giving them a direct reservation.
Don't you think the same argument could be made for other social and educational based reservation as well? We should work, or we should improve the conditions on ground. We should remove social ills. We should remove educational backwardness rather than granting reservation into jobs.
Yes, sir.
Because almost 70 years have passed since the idea of reservation was implemented, right?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the guarantee that if the things have not changed in 70 years, what is the guarantee that it will change in future? If it continues in current form?
Yes, sir. So therefore churning is required, because say few people from all the communities, there are only few people who are getting the benefit of reservation, and a large section of our tribal population, which is still like very backward, they do not even get to schools. And
what I make sense of your argument is that if cream layer concept is introduced in for SC and STs,
yes, sir,
then it could be better, right?
Yes, sir.
And cream layer concept could be introduced on the basis of economic criteria?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you support bringing in economic criteria in SC, ST and reservations, but not for general category?
Yes, sir.
Why is that?
Sir, because SC, ST is a section of population which have been historically deprived. So they do not have a social and cultural capital that people from general communities have. So here their deprivation is only economical. But in the other sense, in the other sector where SCST population, there is deprivation of all the like they do not have social capital, cultural capital and economic capital. But I believe that when these people, they get very high paid jobs, when they become IAS, IPS, they accumulate that capital also. Even SCST people have social and cultural capital. So they should not be given reservation then. But then there is a other section of population which is still are deprived in all the three capitals. So they should be given reservation.
Okay. Tell me about Digital Media Ethics Code 2021.
Sir, it is a set of principles which digital media has to follow. And it has like several rules. Like, first of all, they have to behave responsibly for all the laws of the land. They have to appoint a nodal officer for all kind of complaints. They have to redress the grievance of people. And apart from that, they also have to trace the source of the origin of certain messages. They have to display a code of ethics for them, for their platform. And if a user wants to get verification, like blue tick verification, they have to give it to them.
And the regulatory architecture in these rules, it is self-regulatory or some outside body is proposed to be formed for the regulation?
Sir, till now it was self-regulation only, the Indian Institute of...
What rules provide? Rules provide for self-regulation or they provide for some outside body for that?
Sir, for social media, there is no outside body, but for OTT platforms, there are three tier mechanism, and in which the apex body is Ministry of Information and Broadcasting.
Okay, and what are the lower tier bodies?
Sir, the first is like at the publisher level, they have to institute a grievance redressal mechanism, and then the self-appointing body of all these OTT platforms is the second tier, and the third is the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting.
Okay, so do you think we need such kind of regulatory systems? Don't you think it will be over-regulation and it will hamper creativity?
No, sir. I believe that certain amount of regulation is required because a lot of content is being put in public. Our children are watching it, and they may have certain consequences regarding integrity of India or like for public disorder, etc. So a certain amount of regulation is required. But that should like respect the creativity and free speech. And apart from that, all the content on TV and cinema theaters, they are being regulated. And means I do not have a reason to think that it has hampered creativity. We are watching a lot of good Indian movies.
Social media has democratized the content creation.
Yes, sir.
Can you say that?
Yes, sir.
And these kind of rules, they'll hamper the gain achieved by that. Because currently the mainstream media does not show, or there are claims that it does not show the true picture of ground realities many a times. Okay? When we have some social media journalists, we do have some social media journalists, they are trying their best to come out with good content or good information which mainstream media is missing.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think such kind of rules and regulations will hamper them?
No, sir. Means we have freedom of speech, but even our constitution puts certain constraints on that. And these regulations only are for those constraints, that we should not make a defamatory speech or we should not incite violence or public riots. So means I believe that the reasonable speech is not being curtailed. Only certain sections like people who troll, who put something which outrages the modesty of a woman. But such content has to be regulated. We cannot give a free hand to everybody.
Okay. You are currently in Indian Information Service.
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about your job.
Sir, right now I'm posted in Bureau of Outreach Communication. This is my on-the-job training. Like, we are being posted for 2 months in all the media units. Sir, basically, we work for dissemination of all the information from the government to the citizens. We also work as intermediary between media and the government. And apart from that, we also handle All India Radio and Doordarshan.
Okay. Do you like your job?
Yes, sir.
Then why you are aiming for higher services?
Sir, because I believe that being an IAS, I will be able to work at grassroots level, and at the later stage of my career, I'll be able to contribute in policy making, and this is what attracts me.
What would be your contribution as Indian, a member of Indian Information Service in society? Do we need such service?
Yes, sir. Definitely, we need this service, and today is the age of information. Information has become so much important, and therefore, like, there's a lot of good policies, programs of government, but many people are unaware of it. So there must be a good communication from the government to the people about what government is doing. Apart from that, it also helps people to hold the government accountable, because only when they will have the information, they will be empowered and they can ask for what is due to them.
Tell me one slogan which will you frame for bringing awareness about population control, and that slogan should be Hindi.
Bacche kare utna hi jinko de sake achhi shiksha, or something like that. Means I'm not able to come up with a very catchy slogan, but something on that line, which conveys the meaning that their value addition is more important. Whether you can give them good education and good health facilities, that is more important rather than having a lot of children.
What is vision of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting? The vision statement.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of the exact vision statement.
Okay. Gaurav,
very recently you talked about reservation.
Yes, sir.
What are your ideas with respect to extension of reservation to the minorities, both religious and linguistic?
Sir, I believe that the SCST communities of minority should be given reservation. But minority per se, because only if we see the demographics, the Muslim minorities, somebody as per the Satcher committee report, they are really backward. Other minorities usually do better than the average. And in Muslim minorities, we already have OBC communities and ST communities they have. So they are being given reservation. Apart from that, there are certain institutions like Jamia Millia Islamia and Aligarh Muslim University which give 50% reservation to these communities. So I believe that it is enough.
Gaurav, you are presently an officer trainee in the Indian Information Services. What is the motto of Indian Information Service?
Sorry, I do not remember it.
Okay, you must be aware that in the wake of the abrogation of special status, even under Article 370.
Yes, sir.
Access to internet was banned in the valley.
Yes, sir.
Do you support that?
Sir, I believe that restriction of the access to internet should be the last resort. Like, we should try everything else before shutting off the internet.
What about this move specifically?
Sir, if we do not have any other option, then we have to shut the internet. Because if it is creating public riots, or if it is helping terrorists or some insurgents to create a ruckus, then we do not have other option but to shut down the internet.
So you support that move?
As a last resort, yes.
No, specifically this move of the government. Obviously, it is a safe answer.
Yes, sir. Sir, in Jammu and Kashmir, I believe that it was extended for a very long time. It should have been restored a bit earlier.
So you support the initial imposition, but not its sustenance?
Yes, sir.
Tell me two steps which we can adopt as a society to create awareness with respect to free flow of information. Two steps as a society that we can adopt.
Sir, I beg your pardon, can you please repeat your question?
I'm asking you, Gaurav.
Yes, sir.
Tell me two steps that, as a society, we can adopt or we can take which can improve the free flow of information in the society?
Sir, internet has democratized the flow of information. So if there is more penetration of internet, and that too in rural areas, that will improve the flow of information. And as a society, I believe that we should create a culture where we listen to other people. Like even superiors listen to their subordinates, parents listen to their kids, and they should value their opinion. Because if they will start valuing the opinion of others, other people will also be upfront and upcoming with new views and thoughts. And that will improve the flow.
That would be the first step.
Yes, sir.
Second step?
Sir, maybe like we should improve the level of education, because education empowers people. And even if a lot of information is available, an illiterate or uneducated person cannot make use of that information. He will not be benefited from that information. So education will help the free flow of information.
Gaurav, clay modeling also happens to be your hobby. That's very interesting. Tell me something about clay modeling.
Sir, I make small sculptures out of clay. Like small statues of Lord Ganesh, our face mask, our flower parts, etc.
Okay. What are the four basic techniques of sculpture or clay modeling? Four basic techniques.
Sir, one means I'm not aware of any like technical names, but from my knowledge, if I try to attempt this question, one is like using a material like clay, where we add things. Like we'll keep on adding a more material to make a sculpture. And then there are sculptures made carved out of a stone, that is reductive technique, where we chisel out the material from the stone to create a sculpture.
Have you heard something like graving, casting, modeling, assembling?
Yes, sir, I have heard.
You have heard about this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You talked about addition or subtraction of
yes,
clay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
What's the difference between ball clay and fire clay?
Sir, fire clay, like after the clay is fired in a kiln, it turns into a brick. Basically, certain chemical reaction happens and it becomes very hard. So, it will not melt in rain or it will not absorb a lot of water. But if the clay is like raw, it will absorb a lot of water and it will lose its shape.
Hmm. And what about ball clay?
Sir, ball clay, I'm not aware.
Gaurav, what makes you angry? Tell me one thing that makes you furious.
Sir, usually I'm not a person who show a lot of anger. But yes, I do feel angry at times when I feel betrayed by somebody.
Okay, betrayal.
Yes, sir.
Is something which makes you very angry. Okay, do you think when the government, it changed the Supreme Court decision on Shabanu?
Yes, sir.
It betrayed the people of India?
Yes, sir. I do not favor that legislation that challenged the Supreme Court, that changed the Supreme Court.
Can you tell me the legislation? What was it?
Sir, I do not remember the exact name, but it was Muslim Women Protection of...
What was the subject matter that was changed?
Sir, it was before, like, if a man divorces his wife, Supreme Court said that he has to give sustenance to his wife. But... Yes, maintenance to his wife, but the legislation changed it and it said that he will give maintenance just for 3 months, and if after that a wife is living with his own family, her own family, then that is not required.
So you consider that legislation as a form of betrayal?
Sir, I would not say betrayal, but that was definitely not a good legislation. It was not in public welfare.
Did the parliament redeem itself by abolishing triple talaq?
Yes, sir.
Can you see any connection between these two legislations? One which was passed in 1985-86 session and the one which was done in 2019 session?
Sir, like that legislation, it relied very heavily upon the Muslim code of marriage. But now, like this triple talaq that has been abolished, we are moving towards a uniform civil code where if a certain provision of...
Do you support the idea of a UCC, uniform civil code?
Sir, UCC should be brought up to the extent that it remedies the suppression of a certain section of society. So, if there is any provision which disadvantages women or any caste or any religion, that should be abolished. But apart from that, if there is a harmless provision which makes a community unique in certain ways, I do not think that we need to get away with it.
Okay. If you have to choose between one, rules versus morals, what will you choose?
Sir, in my personal life, I will choose morals, but in public life, I would choose rules.
Rules?
Yes, sir.
Suppose you are the district administrator,
yes,
head, or you are the district collector, and suppose you see that an old lady is being denied pension,
yes, sir,
because she lacks papers.
Yes, sir.
Will you then downplay the rules to give her access to the pension?
Yes, sir. Sir, but that will be in that one specific event. But if I will give a free hand to everybody to just act on their moral sense, and in that a whole district, maybe it will not work. Their rules will
be required. So, in this case, you will forego the rules?
Sir, I will try to find out if I can help him in some other way. I will ask if like I can get her document made. And in meanwhile, I will try to give him enough support that she should not be deprived of that benefit.
Okay. What is your philosophy in life? Tell me your philosophy in one line. That's the philosophy of Gaurav, which he always espouses, and he never wants to discard it under any circumstance.
Sir, it is to make other people happy.
What is happiness, Gaurav?
Sir, happiness is a feeling of content, like when we are at peace with ourselves, when we do not desire anything more. What we have, we are content with that. And so that is...
Are you trying to convey that happiness is a spiritual concept? Or is it a material concept?
Sir, I believe it is a mixture of both.
Mixture of both?
Yes.
Which form of happiness would you prefer?
Sir, I would like... Miss, what I meant by a mixture of both is that certain materialism is also required for a person for being happy. He needs certain resources. He needs food on his plate.
Which is higher form of happiness?
I would say spiritual happiness is higher form, but material happiness is also required. We cannot...
Material happiness is instrumental in value. Can we say that word? It leads to spiritual happiness ultimately?
Yes, sir.
So, it has an instrumental value?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Are you aware of the Statue of Unity?
Yes, sir.
Which civil engineering technique has been used to build it?
Sir, I'm not aware of any technique per se, but it is a RCC structure and there is a bronze cladding over it.
You talked of happiness, Gaurav. How do you define success?
Sir, success is getting what a person aspires for, and if that thing is right. So, if a person aspires to be something which is of value to him and to the society and he gets it, that is success.
How do you define failure?
Failure is not able to achieve your goals, what you aspire for, and also stop trying for it. So, until and unless one does not stop trying for success, he is not a failure.
Recently, Gaurav, there was a case of a lady which was very predominant in the news as regards to pension. What was the book? As old as 2 days back.
Sir, she is Bachchan Kaur, who is the oldest pensioner, army pensioner. She died. She was 102 years old.
You talked of pensioner. Good. How will you distinguish between you are currently in the information service? How will you distinguish between information and intelligence?
So, information is any set of data which has been like arranged in a certain way which creates meaning. But intelligence is the ability to draw patterns out of that information, to see certain patterns and to get a conclusion out of that pattern.
So do you think the situations that have happened in India of late, whether it was in Ladakh incursion, whether it was the farmers' agitation, whether it was the earlier roadblock that was there, somewhere intelligence failures have taken place?
Yes, sir. There must have been some intelligence failure, otherwise we would have acted proactively and would have stopped these things.
Where could information have played a role in these situations?
Sir, like if I talk about the incursions, we can have satellite images, we can have drones, etc., regularly monitoring that area. And when like the initial incursion was happening, when the Chinese troops were coming, even that information could have been used and to proactively send them back. And as far as farmers are considered, like police and the administration should have people on ground who can tell about the mood of the people. And right now there is other techniques like social media listening, where people monitor the social media and they try to gauge the mood, how people are feeling, what are being talked on social media, and then like that information can be used to act proactively.
So where is the role of the National Information Service as such, vis-a-vis the free media that we talked about? Why is this happening? The false information is coming out. It's being spread.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are playing a great role. Like now there is a PIB fact check, which is very popular. So we have a WhatsApp and WhatsApp number and email ID. So anybody, if he has a doubt about a certain kind of information, he can send us that information. And we check that information through other authorities. And then we have a Twitter handle. In that we bust all the fake news. So that has become very popular these days. It has a lot of followers. I will accept that this scale is very limited, because we only bust certain information which is related to government. But then there are a lot of fake news that is doing the round, and which we cannot do, because fake news has a lot of shades. Means not every time it is a complete binary of true and false. So there is a certain event and a certain twist is being given to it to give it a certain different color. And so countering fake news is very, very difficult. And I believe that the best remedy for it is to educate our children from a very basic level, that they should not believe everything that they see on internet or in newspaper, because that time has gone.
But why are you talk about the PIB, you talk about your Doordarshan, what is the agency which controls that?
Prasar Bharati.
Why are these information bodies not very popular with the masses?
Oh, sir, because one reason is that we do not work for TRPs. We show content which may not be very popular, but which is required by people, like DD Kisan or like programs on startups. And we give news which is not very sensational, but which is of high significance. One reason. Second reason, I will accept that our content, our graphics, our things are not very great or at par with the many private companies. They have much better graphic designers. They have much better presentation. So we are lacking in that part and we need to improve that.
How can that be done?
Sir, for that we have to do a new recruitment, because in Prasar Bharati recruitment has not been done from a very long time. And we have to pay these people good to attract good people. And I believe that content is the king if we are giving good content. And we also have to see the pulse of the people, somehow what people want. And we have to provide a kind of infotainment. Like we cannot just give very plain vanilla information. If people is not listening it, then it is of no use. So we have to make it interesting, maybe in documentary form or in some other forms.
One of the most popular serials ever in the history of Indian entertainment industry was the Ramayana and the Mahabharata.
Yes, sir.
So why was that tempo not carried forward?
Sir, it was the time when there were no other private channels, but when private channel came, somehow the content of Doordarshan was not that good, or we could not hold the audience.
I remember correctly, during the lockdown also,
yes, sir,
the old series of Ramayana Mahabharata were played.
Yes, sir.
And they once again attracted huge audience.
Yes,
huge.
Sir. Yes, sir.
In spite of the fact that we had all the other media houses also trying to capture eyeballs.
Yes, sir.
So then why are we not learning our lessons from this particular episode?
Sir, yes, we need to learn a lesson and we need to work on it, because Doordarshan has a certain kind of nostalgia that people have about Doordarshan, because being a 90s kid or being the 80s kid, people have grown up watching Doordarshan. So they can relate to those times and those serials. So yes, we can. That is the niche area that where we can do a lot of great things.
Okay, one last question. You give a message regarding the question that you asked about
Population control.
So if I have to ask you to give a message, how will you spread the message of a safe, road safety? You know, road safety, why I'm talking about it? Because almost 1.5 lakh people die every year on Indian roads.
Yes, sir.
More than 1.5 lakhs.
Yes, sir.
It's a huge number.
Yes, sir.
Right? 1.5 lakhs means one death almost every 3-4 minutes.
Yes, sir.
So what message? And how will you spread that message that the roads become a little more safer in the future?
Sir, maybe I will like to influence people's emotional side, like something ki dheere chaliye ghar pe aapka koi intezar kar raha hai, because people have all the information. So intellectual side is not working somehow, and we have to attack the emotional side of people. And this should be spread through social media and through billboards. Maybe certain advertisements can be created based on this theme, that you have a child at home, you have somebody, your mother waiting at home. And I believe that these things can create a lot of impact.
Thank you.
Gaurav, you said that contentment is happiness, right?
Yes, sir.
But don't you think contentment might lead to halt of progress? If you are too much satisfied with something,
yes, sir.
Why would you work for progress?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Means complacency is always not a good thing. But we should have fire to do more things. But it should not turn toxic, that it will make us unhappy. So there is a very fine line between wanting more and being content with what we have. So, and we have to maintain that balance somehow.
Okay. What are your views on building bridges for improving urban transportation? In cities, primarily.
Yes, sir.
We want to improve transportation. We want to decrease traffic jam.
Yes,
sir. And for that, multiple cities are going for building bridges.
Yes, sir.
What are your views on that?
Sir, as the traffic increases, we need to do these great separated intersections, and we need to make these flyovers. So there are many type of intersections that we work on, and as the traffic goes on increasing, we have to transition. Like we have traffic lights, then we have rotary, but rotaries usually take a lot of space and it is not possible at many urban locations.
What I'm trying to say is there are two schools of thought as far as bridges are concerned.
Yes, sir.
One school believes that building bridges will ease the traffic jam, and
yes, sir,
we should pursue that. The second school is that if we build too much bridges, then traffic might get concentrated at a particular place, and it might lead to a bigger traffic jam than what earlier was there.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
because
sir,
while bridges were not there, so yes, traffic was at different intersections, it
yes,
was
sir,
decentralized.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but because of bridges, traffic will get centralized.
Yes, sir.
What do you think?
Sir, I agree that there is a cycle. You improve the road safety and road flow, and there will be more vehicles coming on that road. And again, it will be a jam condition, and then you have to improve it even further. But since our cities are growing, but there are no other option. Like we have seen huge traffic jams, and maybe the solution is to develop our tier 2 cities so that traffic concentration in just few cities will ease out.
Are you in favor of concentrated urban cluster development or decentralized form of development? Example, Mumbai.
Yes, sir.
So Mumbai, what we perceive is it is a bit of decentralized form of development.
Yes, sir.
New cities, whether Amravati or some other cities which are being developed, they are developed as a concentrated zones where residential units and commercial spaces will be together.
Yes, sir.
What kind of development you prefer? The first one or later one?
Sir, I would prefer the later one because, like, if we can walk to our work, because most of the traffic that is we see on our roads is the people who go to office every day and they have to really walk, like travel a lot of distances. So if we can arrange our cities or the patterns is such that people can walk to their work, then there can be nothing better than that.
Give me a relationship between FSI and traffic jams.
Sir, if FSI is more, then traffic jams will be more.
More or less?
Sir, it is floor space ratio.
Yes,
I guess.
That's what I'm talking
floor about. Space floor index. Space ratio. Yes, sir.
So if floor space ratio is less, then traffic jam would be more or less. Give me justification.
Sir, if like floor space ratio is more, it means that there will be many floors in the same space. So a lot of people will be living there. And those lot of people will travel to that place. So there will be more jams.
Don't you think if floor space ratio increases, if we increase FSI, it will improve the vertical transportation and not horizontal transportation? Because as of now, if FSI is less, so there will be multiple pockets of residential areas and commercial spaces.
Yes, sir.
And people will have to travel on the road.
Yes, sir.
But if we create more of vertical space, it might reduce the traffic jam because more people will live there in a particular locality, more space will be available. What is, according to you, as far as residential units are concerned, what is good form of housing development, bungalows or flats?
Sir, it will depend on the kind of area we are living in.
Let us say Delhi.
Delhi, flats.
Flats.
Yes, sir.
Why flats? Because on particular patch of land, we can build more houses.
Yes, sir.
It will require lesser transport infrastructure.
Yes, sir.
And we'll have more land available for transportation.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So that is what the argument is, that if we increase FSI, then it will improve vertical transportation. We might not need that horizontal transportation.
Yes.
Too much.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So my question is again that why FSI is less in multiple cities, even if the geographical conditions permit more FSI? Why municipalities and state government is adamant on keeping FSI low?
Sir, because it puts a lot of pressure on other infrastructure like sewage treatment plants, water supply, etc. So, like, we cannot just go on increasing the FSI because we have to have that system also of water supply, of sewage treatment plants and other facilities that people require, like municipal solid waste, etc.
Okay, have you heard about toll operate transfer model, TOD model?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Sir, this is basically a PPP model, public-private partnership, in which a private company, they come up with all the capital, they build the road, and after completion of the road, they collect toll from the road, and then they recover their cost, and then they transfer that road to the government.
Are you sure about?
Sir, it is the toll operate toll model.
Toll operate transfer model.
Yes, sir.
TOT.
Yes, sir.
So the road is being built by
a private company.
Private.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it like the road is being built by NHAI? NHAI operates this for at least 2-3 years.
Yes, sir.
And when the toll viability occurs,
yes, sir,
it is being transferred to private player and NHAI recovers the money and NHAI puts that money in some other projects.
Sir, that is basically monetization of already constructed infrastructure.
That is TOD model.
Okay, sir, then I might have some confusion.
Okay,
I'll check it.
Tell me about cubism in painting. What is it?
Sir, cubism is basically a school of painting in which a structure, it is bifurcated in various cubical, geometrical and cubical forms. And it is also considered one of the modernist art, and M.F. Hussain and S.H. Raza, etc.
Who was the pioneer?
Sir, I'm not aware of it.
Have you heard about Shamikshava?
Yes.
It is the first indigenous art movement in modern India. Samikshavad.
Okay, sir. Sir, I'll read about it. I'm not aware of it.
Okay. Establish a connection between painting and pluralism.
Sir, paintings, like if we see modern paintings, like they use various forms of various folk arts and even the modern art. They take cues from various traditions and cultures of India. And in that way, they create a plural thing. And the other thing is that the painting, we use different colors, we use different techniques. It is never black and white. It is never monochrome. It is always a multichrome. And that is, in a way, pluralism. And this is what it makes a painting more beautiful, more colors, more uniqueness, more distinctiveness in a painting, more contrast.
Gaurav, what's the meaning of your name?
Sir, it means pride.
Tell me one thing of which you are proud about.
Sir, I'm proud about that I'm a good human being.
You're a good human being?
Yes, sir.
How do you define a good human being?
A person who is filled with humanity and compassion.
Okay.
Yes.
Are you compassionate towards the weaker sections of the society?
Yes, sir.
Do you think that a civil servant is accountability and responsibility, both moral and legal responsibility, they enhance where there are more demographic, more economic, more social challenges involved?
Yes, sir. Yes? Definitely. Yes.
So if you believe in that,
yes, sir.
This surprises me, Gaurav, that you have opted for Zone 4 as your last choice. And what is more bewildering is in that Nagaland happens to be your last choice, which is demographically,
yes, sir.
Politically, economically, socially, from the security point of view, technologically, very deprived.
Yes, sir.
Is this your biasness towards the Northeast?
No, sir, I would not say that it is my biasness. Like, I have opted Uttar Pradesh as my first choice, and even if I see in Uttar Pradesh, there is a lot of backwardness. My reason for choosing Northeast, like, at last, is that I believe that I do not know the language, I do not know the local ethos. So maybe I will not be a suitable, more suitable candidate than a person who is locally from there. I can do good, but maybe I'll be more suitable for a region like UP or MP, which I'm more aware of it, where I have grown. So I can serve those regions better than a far-flung region.
Okay. You are aware of UP and Bihar?
Yes, sir.
How many districts in Bihar?
Sorry, sir. I'm not. I don't have that actually.
Gaurav, Indian Police Service happens to be a fourth choice.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And you're not the first person to make a lower choice preference for the Indian Police Service.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think that there should be a separate examination for the Indian Police Services on the lines of Indian Forest Services? Because then only we will have motivated candidates who actually want him to go to the Indian Police Services. Today, the Indian Police Service is filled with disgruntled aspirants of the IAS. Those who fail to go into the IAS, they land up into the IPS. It's a compromise for them. Don't you think that there should be a separate examination for Indian Police Service? Do you agree to this, Gaurav, that we want passionate and dedicated persons for maintenance of law and order?
Yes, sir, definitely. There's no doubt about it.
On similar lines, there are examinations in the US?
Yes.
Don't you think that in India should also adopt that?
Sir, I believe that even in like the people who give civil services, there are many people who fill IPS as their first choice. So, and there is, if I see that they will need a knowledge of all that we do in civil services. And then there is this, all these services are very much interconnected. So when like they do foundation, they know people from other services. There is a kind of interconnectedness. They know about other services and it makes the administration easier.
Okay, one last question, Gaurav. Why do you want to join the IAS?
Sir, honestly, it is my childhood dream. And I believe that being in IAS, I can work at the grassroots level. And I can also influence policy making. And apart from that, it provides me better career growth and opportunities.
Mm-hmm. India want what kinds of policies today? Sir,
policies which are based on hard facts, evidence, data, and which is also compassionate towards weaker section of our people, and which works toward reducing the inequality, because inequality in India is growing.
Gaurav, thank you very much. It was lovely interacting with you.
Thank you.
Please wait outside. We'll call you again for your feedback.
Okay. Thank you. Sir. Congratulations.
Gaurav, good things first. Overall, very good performance.
Yes.
You appeared very decent and polite throughout the interview. And you were able to put your arguments also. You defended them reasonably well.
Yes, sir.
But because this is a critical analysis,
yes, sir.
Let me highlight some of the flaws which I have identified.
Yes, sir.
First is the eye contact here.
Mm.
It was really poor.
Mm.
See,
mm.
when somebody asks you a question,
mm.
you must look at that person in an attentive manner.
Mm.
But when you start answering,
mm.
you should predominantly look at the person who has asked you the question.
Mm.
But in the meanwhile, you should also pass some soft glances to the other members of the panel as well. Otherwise,
yes.
they might feel left out.
Yes.
You may even take offense. Do you understand that?
Yes,
it should be detrimental to your cause. That's first thing. Second, your armpits, I'm sorry to say, were sweating.
Yes, sir.
It shows nervousness.
Yes, sir.
Clear? So work on that.
Okay.
You can control that. Wear a color of shirt so that it doesn't appear so explicit.
Yes, sir.
Failing to answer something related to you is unfair.
Yes, sir.
You can fail in some other areas, but you cannot fail on areas which are related to you. It means you're deaf.
Yes, sir.
Like you were not aware about the World Theatre Day.
Yes, sir.
You were not aware of that. But you answered good with respect to the questions that were raised in and around Azamgarh. Statistics were also very perfect and geographically also said correctly. Aruna Asafali, because your address reads
yes,
Aruna Asafali, that's why I asked you that question. Rajbhasha Department, even your department celebrates
yes,
the Hindi Sapta and the Pakwada.
Yes,
you are in the service.
Yes, sir.
It is unpardonable.
Yes.
Yeah. So you must, and Hindi happens to be your mother tongue.
Mother tongue.
So there is a lot of connection in that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you must answer things with respect to that. Civil engineering, Gaurav, again, the performance was very suboptimal because not only you are a graduate in civil engineering, you are a postgraduate, a gold medalist, and it happens to be your optional subject.
Yes, sir.
And if you are failing on questions like geomechanical inverse modeling, which is very basic. Civil engineering, you must brush up your concepts.
Sir, honestly, I have never heard about it.
It's a recent research which is going on here.
Okay, so should I like read about research?
Yes, obviously.
Okay.
Just go to Google and find out top researches in civil engineering because
okay.
they would be focusing on that.
Yes, sir.
Do you think they will ask you what is angle of ribbons?
No, sir.
Definitely.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So read about those things. And if clay modeling happens to be your hobby,
yes, sir.
Painting was handled very well.
Yes, sir.
Even a question which was asked with respect to pluralism and painting, you handled that beautifully. But clay modeling, you were not aware of the different techniques. In fact,
yes,
you were talking about carving.
Mm-hmm.
But you did not, you were not aware of its technical name.
Yes, sir.
You must know about it because hobby is something dear which you passionately pursue.
Yes, sir.
It is not a leisure kind of interest.
Yes, sir.
It's a passion for you. So you must improve on that as well. Motto of the Indian Information Services, again, a question. Because see, your knowledge is not being tested here.
Yes, sir.
The idea is to test your personality, awareness, values, virtues, your skills, your behavior, how proactive you are. And the whole idea is to check whether you can be trained or not.
Yes.
That's it. Otherwise, you are misfit into the system. A question which was raised with respect to reservation.
Yes, sir.
There you unnecessarily dragged the argument, which was not warranted. Why I would say so? Because government has made a decision. You cannot keep on criticizing the government for its decision. You may hold a particular view. But when the situation is getting into a confrontationist kind of stand, you must slowly and very politely withdraw from that situation.
Okay.
And you should never criticize government decisions so abruptly. You can always suggest. The suggestions were very good, but you were blunt in one way I do not say. To my mind. It doesn't, these sentences are not good. They are not bureaucratic.
Yes.
One major flaw which I have observed, and maybe that's a problem with your generation also, is the language.
Yes, sir.
The tenor of your voice, the tone of your voice. Though you appeared very polite and very decent, but at times there was this Yankee touch to it. You understand the Yankee touch? The American touch to it.
Okay.
Okay. Like you said, that I would also like to think so, but on the other hand, it was like very informal.
Okay.
And there was so much use of the word like, you must have experienced that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah? It is not good, dear. Sentence should be clean,
yes,
should
sir.
Be short,
yes, sir.
And should be said in a very humble manner. Yeah? So that is one thing you should. Otherwise, it shows your non-attentiveness or informalness. Like, you are just
missing light. It doesn't exhibit a very good, it doesn't give a good manifestation. It's not a good reflection on your personality.
Clear.
Otherwise, the zone related question was also handled good. The IPS related question was also handled good. That is what I make of this interaction, Gaurav. Otherwise, lovely. That's my feedback.
Thank you, sir.
Gaurav, entry confident, but between that place and this place, I saw that there was a sudden dip in your confidence.
Yes, sir.
Your body position is revealing your lack of confidence between there and there.
Yes.
So, as far as possible, avoid keeping your hands in front of you with this.
Okay.
It shows lack of confidence drastically.
Yes.
And can be caught on very easily.
Yes.
Confident sitting position. But later on, you slouched.
Yes.
Right? Maybe you may have gone on for a little longer, but you have to be prepared for it.
Yes, sir.
I will not expect this position.
Yes, sir.
It doesn't behold well.
Yes, right? Sir.
You should have shaved. You should have shaved.
Yes, sir. Yes.
This is a big occasion.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Right? And you have to put your best forward.
Yes, sir.
So, if you had shaved, you would have added to your, the overall scoring also.
Yes, sir.
Well dressed, but.
Yes, sir.
Get the point?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, at an occasion like this.
Yes, sir.
Whether it is out of lack of confidence or whether it is because of your physical characteristics, could be either.
Yes, sir.
Make sure that you dress according to the occasion so that it is not visible to the other.
Yes, sir.
Because for a person, a layman, I will presume it is lack of confidence.
Yes.
The room is air conditioned.
Yes, sir.
But yet you are sweating, no one else is sweating.
Yes.
So, it should not be visible at least.
Yes, sir.
Right? Good. Good foot position, but your hand movement, it was varying all through. Sometimes you kept your arms on your knees, at times you had them locked.
Yes, sir.
But I could see when you had your hands locked, 2-3 fingers were moving. That shows you're not confident. Right? So keep your fingers locked and keep them locked.
Okay.
Don't let your fingers move around. They should not be juggling.
Okay.
Collar button is open.
Yes.
Not right. Okay?
Yes, sir.
You took a lot of guesses. Because when asked a question, you took a guess.
Yes, sir.
But when asked, are you sure? You said, I don't know.
Yes, sir.
Not right.
Yes.
If you're not sure about it, say it at the beginning.
Yes, sir.
I'm not sure, but
I will. Yes, sir. Yes.
So don't say yes and then say I'm not sure.
Yes, sir.
You had a very good, your face was good. You showed, very charming face as such, I should say, but too much of teeth.
Okay.
So curtail it. Little dilution is required there.
Okay.
Eye contact, as like you said.
Yes, sir.
Very, very poor.
Yes.
Very abrupt movements. Abrupt movements means you are avoiding somebody's gaze. I was personally and on purpose staring at you a couple of times. And the moment I did that, I saw you just move. You did this and did that. When you were talking to him, you looked at me, tuck tuck. You did not even look at him at all. When you were looking at him, you stole a glance towards me, tuck tuck, but you did not look at him at all. Not right.
Yes.
As it has been explained, right?
Yes.
In the latter part of the interview, your shoulders started to droop, as I said. When appreciated, or when somebody gave you some news, something which you did not know.
Yes, sir.
You thanked, that was good, well done. Now, you answered questions well, but you are fond of mountaineering, you are fond of adventure activities, you want to the HMI. You do not know the motto of HMI? Well, a little surprising to me, because the motto of HMI is very simple. may you climb from peak to peak.
Okay, so I will read about.
So you should have known that better, right? Overall, I should say, a good performance.
Yes, sir.
But with these little bit of corrections, you are in good.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
For a good part, and language was good.
Yes, sir.
Clarity is good. The Jinna answer was good.
Yes, sir.
Why Prasar Bharati and PIB are not popular, that was beautifully explained. Very good. Bad parts.
Yes, sir.
Shaving.
Yes, sir.
It should be there. Eye contact was the biggest problem.
Yes, sir.
It was almost missing. What I was feeling was that, I don't know what you did in your last interview, but I think you believe that you should stare only at a person who is asking questions. That was your perception.
No, sir. I try it, but like in the flow, like I miss, when I look a lot of people, then I forget what I'm speaking. So just to like maintain my flow, I try avoid it. But I know that I have to look at all the this,
okay,
and I will work
you
on
know
it.
That.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You should work on that. It will improve your marks by around 10 to 15 easily.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Too much smiling. Your smile is good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is charming.
Mm-hmm.
But too much smile is bad.
Okay.
It shows your informalness.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay,
and sometimes as sir said, your tone was a bit frank.
Okay.
Such as you are talking with your friend or something.
Okay.
So you should avoid that.
Okay.
It is a formal communication.
Yes,
and
sir.
You should make it.
Okay, sir.
Okay, but you should have a smile also.
Yes, sir.
A decent smile.
Yes, sir.
If you are not sure about something, say that in advance.
Yes, sir.
Not after
yes,
being contradictory.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you are not aware about your own department, your ministry, mission, or
sir,
that's,
I will read,
sounds
I'll read
very good of you.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
you should work on that.
Okay, sir.
And you are civil engineer, and you are not. You are less sure about toll operator transfer model and all. The relationship between FSI and traffic jams.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it is although it is a research area, there are two schools of thought. You said that also is right, and what I am saying is also right.
Yes, sir.
But you should put forward the both schools of thought.
Hmm.
That one section believes that, and one section believes that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And EWS stand was very poor. You should not take such kind of stand. Government has already went ahead with this reservation.
Mm-hmm.
You have to support.
Hmm.
Why you were deliberately trying to get into confrontation? What is the easy way is you support government. And then you can qualify it with one or two statement.
Okay.
But that is it.
Okay.
But primarily you have to support.
Okay.
That is what we do in mains. When
yes,
you
sir.
Have
yes,
written mains, you
yes,
have
sir.
Done that only, right?
Yes, sir.
So why not an interview?
Yes, sir.
Do the same thing. Support
yes,
government. And if you want to qualify, add one or two statement. That
okay.
is it.
Okay.
But primary answer should be in support of government.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
That is all from my side. Otherwise, good.
Thank you, sir.
Gaurav, what was your score last time?
Sir, 193.
So, maybe the flaws that existed have persisted.
Yes, sir.
That's why, based purely on this interview,
yes, sir.
And by averaging out the individual score given by the honorable members,
yes, sir.
We feel that if you go like this, you will land up again into the territory of 180 to 190.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But if you work on these flaws, dear.
Yes.
Then definitely you are a 205 kind of candidate. And you can understand 10-15 marks is
yes,
all the difference.
Yes, sir. Yes,
you
sir.
Know it.
Yes, sir.
Here by your personal experience.
Yes, sir.
If you have any specific questions, you can go ahead.
No, sir, just I have to work on these things like I know. And about the smile thing, like I have been told a lot earlier that I become very serious. So this time I try to consciously smile more, but maybe I overdid it.
You overdid it.
Yes, yes.
Overdid it. Cut the like
yes,
from
sir.
Your sentences.
Yes, sir.
It's too much of like.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very informal, dear.
Yes, sir.
Have you heard any government officials speaking like that?
No, sir.
No. Yeah. And secondly, you see that you appear otherwise a very good candidate.
Yes,
you're polite and decent.
Yes,
that's
sir.
The biggest attribute that you possess.
Yes,
but as rightly pointed out by
yes,
the
sir.
Other members,
yes,
that you must work on your flaws.
Okay, sir.
No extreme stunts
yes, sir.
In the interview.
Yes, sir.
डिबेट थोड़ी ना हो रही है, आपको जीतना थोड़ी ना है,
यस सर,
ठीक है, हार जाओगे क्या फर्क पड़ता है,
यस सर,
पर्सनालिटी चेक हो रहा है ना,
यस सर, यस सर,
यार ठीक है,
यस सर,
तो अंडरस्टैंड करते
हैं, यस सर,
सो यू कैन कम ओवर एंड कलेक्ट योर फीडबैक शीट्स,
ओके,
ऑल द बेस्ट,
थैंक यू सर,
व्हेन इज योर इंटरव्यू स्लॉट,
सर 13th मई,
यू हैव टाइम,
यस सर,
इंप्रूव,
यस,
श्योरली यू विल बी,
यस सर, थैंक यू सर, थैंक्स.